there's a reason Arkansas is known far and wide for its superb duck hunting. Thanks to its position at the neck of the migratory funnel, the natural state serves as the winter home to millions of ducks and geese. But circumstances on the other end of the flyway have an even bigger influence on duck populations and Arkansas duck hunting.
Frankly, if you look at band return information, if you look where the ducks come from, ducks harvested in Arkansas are banded in Saskatchewan in a big way. There's some more from other prairie provinces, but really Saskatchewan is the core of Arkansas's waterfowl.
Prairie Canada produces millions of ducks each year, which is the reason the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission has contributed funds for the past 50 years to conserve important waterfowl habitats here in Saskatchewan.
The North American Waterfowl Management Plan is a critical plan that started in the mid-1980s. This plan was really about Canada, the U.S., and Mexico all coming together to make sure that the future of waterfowl was protected.
An aerial view of the Allan-Dana Hills of central Saskatchewan reveals the area's value to ducks. Thousands of small potholes mark the landscape. These shallow ponds, gouged by glaciers, provide habitat for breeding pairs as well as habitat for hens to raise broods until they're strong enough to migrate thousands of miles. But ducks also need nesting cover that's relatively close to the potholes. Native prairie grasslands provide the best habitat.
It's an absolutely critical area. You've got this area that's got extremely high wetland densities like those in behind me here. And talk about a place for waterfowl to be produced. This is such a broad landscape of wetlands that we need the grasslands. We need the acres of habitat to give a duck a chance. Every duck nest has about an 85% chance of failing.
Ducks face many challenges to survival, and not all of them come from the natural world. During a June trip to Saskatchewan, representatives from the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission saw firsthand how changing land use practices are diminishing habitat. From an elevation of several hundred feet, you get a clear indication of how wetland drainage and the conversion of native grassland to cropland are changing the landscape. Driving a tractor or combine around a pothole in the middle of a crop field isn't always efficient or convenient, which leads some farmers to drain wetlands. Others are breaking native prairie to increase crop production.
Wetland drainage is something that's real in this province. We don't have wetland policy that really protects wetlands. So what we have is we have landowners that are out there and trying to make another dollar on their farm, and you can't blame them for that. But they drain the wetlands, which loses the productivity of the landscape for waterfowl. The other factors on the landscape are really the grasslands. For years, this land was converted from grassland into agricultural annual cropping. What we're trying to do now is reverse some of that trend, primarily in the high waterfowl wetland density areas.
Ducks Unlimited Canada protects waterfowl habitat in many ways, including conservation easements, land purchases, and landowner incentive programs.
We put more grass on the ground. We put the right types of habitat on the ground. We work with landowners and make a landscape change that really results in sustainable habitats for waterfowl up here in Saskatchewan.
Kyle Buckle is a fourth generation farmer in Bruno, Saskatchewan. He works frequently with DU Canada to conserve wildlife habitat while also boosting income on his 5,500 acre farm.
When we were young and ambitious, Dad's like, we'll break it, eh? So we broke it all. And now this is all that's remaining is this one narrow piece, eh? But otherwise it would have been all like this, eh? But that was before ducks was paying the money they are now.
We want to provide incentives. We want to work on ecological goods and services for landowners. That's really looking at what's that value to the public that wetland provides. That's really what we need to do in order to get wetlands back.
Conserving waterfowl habitat requires money, and because ducks don't know international boundaries, ensuring the future of duck hunting on the wintering grounds requires a flow of money from the U.S. to Canada. Working with North American Wetlands Conservation Act, or NACA grants, Arkansas and other states contribute funds to conserve Canadian habitats that produce ducks that end up on our end of the flyway. With federal and private matching funds on both sides of the border, Arkansas's investment grows exponentially.
The state dollar gets matched by a Ducks Unlimited dollar, and then those get matched by NACA. And then it comes to Canada, and Canadian partners match it, like DU Canada, Environment Canada, and others. It's this leveraging that really results in conservation on a large scale. Those dollars are so critical to making that difference and leveraging and causing the future of waterfowl conservation being secured in the Prairie of Canada.